G'day, g'day, I'm Steamin STIX, your favourite mediocre musician. I thought I was going to do so much more of these. Welcome back to My Thoughts. Today we'll be checking out the song Supalonely by Benee. I'll be honest, I've had a really mentally draining, down in the dumps, case of the morbs kind of depression the last couple of weeks. But I heard this song on the radio when I was coming home after a really long day of work. This is 1 p.m. that I'm coming home, by the way. And the rest of my day I was planning on just sleeping through it all. But as I was nearly home, this song came on and I was kind of grooving to it. And it made things seem okay for a little bit. So I want to listen to it properly and talk about it. But a bit of a change of rules for how My Thoughts is going to go. I'll still be rating lyrics, music, and the video, but instead I'm going to rate them out of 5 instead of 10 because I found 10 was too broader a range. So 1 is hate it, 3 is meh, and 5 is love it. I'm already going to assume that this song's probably going to already get 4s and 5s because I already know I liked it. I wouldn't mind doing some videos on songs that I end up not liking, but if a song I like gets me motivated to do the thing, then I'm gonna do it. I still need to do that song that Screezilla told me to do. I have a feeling I'm not gonna be fond of that one. Might do it later. I also decided I actually don't like doing any research, so I'm not gonna look up background info on the artist unless I'm really compelled to. Or I might just keep it to a short sweet. This is how they started, this is where they are now. It'll all depend on what I feel like. And with that, let's get to it and have a quick listen to Supalonely by Benee. Ping! Look how nice this setup is now. Now it can look somewhat professional. But anyway, let's watch the thing.
I hope it's the right video clip.
Yeah, that song was just all the feels I had last week. I like the starting video because she's, you know, moping around while having a bowl of cereal, and this cover that I'm working on, like, that's exactly what I'm gonna do in it. So if you see me just, if you see the cover that I'm going to do and see me moping around a bowl of cereal, I was already planning on doing that. I didn't do it because I saw this video. I was already planning on it. But yeah, video-wise, I think the video is pretty great because the song and the music is just so boppy, chill, groovy, all that sort of stuff. And then so in the video at certain points, you know, she's acting all happy and mucking around and all that sort of caper. But then of course the lyrics are quite depressing. I think she was saying, where am I supposed to be? What should I be doing? Where should I be right now? I think when she mentions her friends know about it, but they're not doing anything about it. Because I think she says something along the lines of, my friends know, but I'm the bad friend. So I think her friends know she's going through something, but they're not making the allowance or leniency to just be like, yeah, she's going through a tough time, that's maybe why she's bailing and, you know, being really closed off at the moment. Or the fact that her friends know she's going through a hard time and they're just like, I don't want to deal with that, so sort yourself out. So now she's lonely. Because back to with the cover that I'm working on and, you know, want to do the, you know, the sad cereal scene. The vocals are one of the hardest parts for me to record in a song. And that's largely because I don't think I'm very good at vocals and I don't really know what I'm doing with them. But last weekend I had gotten all my vocals finished and whatnot. And then just because of the depressive mood I was in, normally I would have posted being like, oh yeah, it's all done. But yeah, because of how I was feeling, I was like, no one cares. No one's, you know, no one's gonna watch the video anyway, so So it doesn't matter if I post that I've, you know, finished another section of it. But back to the actual song. Yeah, it's just all great in my opinion. I like the sound of Benee's voice. It's just really kind of cute and chilled, I think. And with the chorus, because that's running through my head more than what I remember with the lyrics, I think the lyrics are very true to what you would be telling yourself if you're, you know, having one of those kind of moods. Because, you know, she's saying she's effed up, she's a loser, and, you know, she's super lonely. So again, there's a bit of isolation she's feeling with herself because she obviously doesn't feel like she can connect or reach out to anyone, or that anyone can really help her through it, which is all very relatable. But I like the tone of the music very much because it just sounds a lot happier than what she's actually saying. And I really like songs that do that, where they've got like a really sad sounding song, but then the lyrics are super happy, or the music sounds really happy and the lyrics are really sad.
I definitely would like to be able to write a song like that one day.
I guess I can give it a rating now. The lyrics, I'm just gonna straight up give it a 5. I find the lyrics from what I've heard, it's very relatable, and again with my mindset at the time from when I first heard it and still now, it's just, yes, I feel very relatable and connected to it. So yes, I love the lyrics. Music as well, maybe just a 4. Yeah, I do like the music. Like, it's, lyrics are sad, music is happy, and it's just being like, everything's crap, but ha la 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 la, we don't care, it's all this. I love it, I love it, I love it. Music works well. The video, maybe a 3.5. I can't quite decide if I find it a bit meh or I do like it. I think it's a 3.7. Because again, I feel like half the video, she's bouncing around acting happy to match the music. And then of course she's more serious in the verses because she's lonely and she feels like shit. So,
yes. Yes, I will leave it at a 3.7.
I think I forgot to mention in the beginning of the video that I am assessing the song from when I first hear it, and then I'll study it a little bit and see if I like it more or less after looking at it in detail. I really want to look at the lyrics in more detail, especially the guy's part. I don't know why, I just couldn't concentrate on what he was saying at that bit, so that kind of... So yeah, I wanna study the lyrics more of this song. So let's just kind of leave it there for our first thoughts. I totally forgot if I ranked everything for a second there. Lyrics, music, video. Yes, no, yeah, I did, yeah. Now let's fade back into later when I do a bit more studying. Let's turn a flippin' light on. Ah, blind. Because I didn't realise that the video quality would be bad due to lack of light until after I showed Mum the first half of this. Because I was proud until I saw it was bad. Thought I'd do my hair different so you knew it was a different day since I'm wearing the same shirt. This is my One OK Rock shirt that I got from their concert this year before all the restrictions. So we have done a week of studying and I'm quite glad to say that what I first thought the lyrics and the meaning of the song was about, it's kind of still like that, but there's also another kind of narrative that's going on there that I really liked. So I'm gonna start by going through the lyrics section by section. So in the chorus, she's realised she's made a mistake about the person she's with and wants to break up. I imagine the boyfriend is going out drinking a lot and then she's kind of staying at home by herself. So she's kind of just in a corner being sad and lonely and wondering what's the point of this whole relationship if she's feeling lonely from it. Which is pretty fair to say. I mean, you kind of get into a relationship because you want to be with someone. So it doesn't quite work if you're not together most of the time and actually feeling super lonely from it. The first verse, I think she's describing the feelings that she's now feeling because she's now initiated the breakup. So it's all kind of pouring down and weighing down on her, which I don't really kind of know how to explain other than a feeling of but she knew she would have to do it, but now that it's going through the motions, it's still a lot for her to take in. And now she's questioning if she's even in the right about wanting to break up, and also wondering if she's just thinking way too much about it and making it a bigger problem than what it actually is. In the pre-chorus, she feels really sad about the whole ordeal and feels really small amongst all of this. As opposed to when I first heard the song, I thought her friends weren't being supportive or caring about the situation, but now I think the meaning is they know what's happened and they agree that the partner is being bad or in the wrong. So I would hope that means that her friends are being supportive and are there for her, and it's just the relationship that is the main cause of her loneliness at this point in time. And we got another chorus, and the post-chorus are all the la 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 bits. That's just a nice dandy singing bit. Verse 2, I think, is now her dealing with her feelings after doing all of the breakup process. So the act of breaking up is done, and now she's kind of left to mourn the relationship that she once had. Because she was still in a relationship, there was still something that that person did or who that person is that was very appealing, and now she's lost the person that she liked. So it's pretty understandable that even though she knew she thought it was best to break up, she's still sad that she now doesn't have that person anymore. Another chorus and another post-chorus. So now we have the bridge with guest vocalist Gus Dapperton. So he's now, I think, saying the partner's response to Benee saying things aren't working and, you know, this is kind of what's going on, what I'm seeing. So Gus is saying he's not very good at the romantic side of things. And in the chorus, Benee refers to him just going out and drinking. But although he's going out, I think he's just going out to dance and kind of have fun. Because then his lyrics say, I'm only dancing by myself so I don't slam my Irish buck. And I had to look this up. An Irish buck is a drink. So I think what that part means is he's going out, but he's still just by himself and at the very least not cheating on her. And he's out focusing on dancing, so he doesn't drink. I like the next section of the bridge because they say they can't stress this enough, that they don't want to mess up the relationship that they have. But they have to keep going out and dancing because that's their fun and happiness. And I think moreover, who they are sort of thing, not avoiding Benee and not wanting to be with her. But because they're always going out, it's causing her to be lonely and longing for their time and attention. So after X amount of time, it's really just eating away at her. A bit of my life input here. I quite like the bridge because it kind of reminds me of what my relationship has had happen. I had to have a chat with my boyfriend because there was a thing that he really liked doing in it, you know, it was his distraction and peace and all of that from the kind of rough patch and difficult situation we were kind of in. But because he was literally waking up, doing the thing, going to sleep day after day, because that was the only thing he thought he could control and get peace through, that included me being ignored in a way. And so I wasn't really appreciating that and having to fight for his time when everything else was already bad. So everything being crap and then him not giving me any kind of time or attention was not helping me. So when my boyfriend and I actually talked about it, we have figured it out and now we're making things work. So from being able to hear the bridge properly and with a bit of my experience thrown in there as well, if everyone talks and listens to each other, I think a compromise or working through the situation can be achievable. However, I don't think it worked out that way since the rest of the song, I'm pretty sure it's still saying like, yeah, they've broken up. They weren't able to work through it. So yeah, that's kind of sad, but if it can't work through it, then they can't work through it. And I believe we've just got more of the chorus to finish off the song. So this song turned out to be even more relatable to me, not only on the kind of depressive, sad and loneliness side of things, but also in the relationship aspect. So I think they are fantastic lyrics. I give them another 5. Now we can move on to the music. I had a lot of trouble finding words to describe what I was actually meaning, so just bear with me here. The intro was nice. It starts with kind of gentle sort of chords with almost a muffled kind of beat behind it. Then when she starts singing, the beat gets heavier and much clearer. And I, for one, get into an immediate groove right from the start with it. I think the feel and style of the song has a little bit of a funk to it. It's a really good vibe, and I think the combination of the peaceful, happy kind of chords and then the drums and the bass in a kind of funk style, that really makes you move around and want to dance to it. The way the melody changes and the way her voice comes out, I also think is really interesting. The chorus sounds the most normal and natural, but I do think there is still a little something in there. The verses have a bit more auto-tune to them. I don't actually know what auto-tune does or can do, so I'm not even sure if that's the right word to use. So the effect it gives the melody is kind of a bit techno. Just listen to what I mean when I say that. I've been lonely, water pouring down from the ceiling. I knew this would happen, still hard to believe it. Then we go to the pre-chorus, and there's still just a little bit in there, but not as much. And I think it makes it work really well and adds a bit more intrigue to how the melody goes, and just that little cherry on top for the extra bit of fanciness. The music in this song is very enjoyable. I give it another 4. And now we've just got the video to go. Let's address the cereal scene first. Fantastic! Stole my idea before I even made it myself. I've recently finished a cover with the same kind of depression sort of theme, and one of the first scenes is me moping around to a bowl of cereal. So I think we can all agree that great minds think alike, yeah? So in the verses, she's kind of just around the house, kind of just being there. But not really there, because her mind is trying to wrap her head around all the emotions she's going through. And since there's no one else in the house, it helps to emphasize her complete loneliness. And there's no one to help distract her from that. The colors and lighting, I think, would normally make for a more positive vibe, but she's not having a positive time right now. So it's still trying to show us kind of more stereotypically happy visuals. But in reality, especially with the lyrics still going on, it's a sad moment. The chorus changes and she starts dancing around a little bit more, trying to act like it's not such a big thing. Her lyrics are also saying she doesn't want to be dramatic, so while she's upset and lonely, she's trying to have fun with it and not make it seem to us like it is as bad as it is. For example, for another useless fact about me, I had one of the biggest panic attacks I've ever had, so far, last year. I was supposed to go to my friend's birthday party that night, but then couldn't because of it. Then when we caught up again, I brought it up, but I said it in a kind of, hey, I still need to tell you about that panic attack that made me not able to come to your birthday. Phew, that was a doozy. And then I proceeded to tell her how horrible it was, like it was nothing. So in relation to the video, I think it has a good balance of allowing yourself to be sad, but it's also showing her kind of pretending to be happy by dancing around and making it seem like she is okay. Let's take this moment to talk about me again. So speaking for myself here, I've learnt no one gives a damn that you're going through a rough patch. And after an unknown amount of time, people expect you to be over things and continue on like you're not still hurting. So my realism is, and what I actually tell myself quite often, is the world isn't gonna stop just because you feel sad. So then for myself, I just suck it up, put a face on because no one cares and I'm still broken. And then so I'll bring up hard moments that I had and then play them off as a lot less serious than what I felt in that moment as I was feeling them. Because you're expected to, or have actually had the time to calm down, and now you can process it easier to downplay it. I think Benee neatly shows this as much as you can in a 3.5 minute video clip. It shows moments of sadness and also the appearance of happiness, but the lyrics are telling us it's still sad and everything's still really hard. Having a look at Gus's part now, I don't think there's actually anything too important about his section of the video. He's dancing around, which of course fits his lyrics. So it's his moment of spotlight and camera time while he takes over the melody and says his part. I think Gus's lyrics are a bit more important than the visual, but he still needs his little dance session. Stop hogging all the groove time, Benee. I don't think I had too much to say about the video when I first saw it. So with what I've just mentioned, I'm unsure as to whether I love it or I just like it. So with all of that, I think I will give it a 4.5. I think all of that actually went really well. I would recommend listening to this song in full. I'll have the link of the video that I watched in the description so you can check it out yourselves. Don't forget to put the tally in! So to tally our results, our first thoughts gave us 5 for the lyrics, 4 for music, and 3.7 for the video. Our study thoughts gave us 5 for the lyrics, 4 for the music, and 4.5 for the video, which gives us totals of 12.7 for the first and 13.5 for the study. So it turns out I liked it more after studying it. Thank you for listening to my thoughts on Supalonely by Benee. If you want to leave a suggestion for me to do in future, leave a comment. I might do it. I might. I've got YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and a Tumblr page. So, you know, if you want to like and subscribe to any of those, the links will be in the description. Again, thanks for watching, and with that, I'm off to bed. Night night. Mm-hmm.